Hey, what's up everyone? Greg's Gadgets here with an unboxing of the Black Magic Keyboard. Now, this keyboard was just freshly announced when Apple did its education event. They actually made both the Magic Keyboard and the Magic Touchpad, Magic Mouse, all available in black that was previously only available on the iMac Pro. So let's go ahead and do a quick unboxing here of the Black Magic Keyboard. Now, I know you might be saying it's not actually the Black Magic Keyboard. I know it's called the Space Gray Magic Keyboard, but, you know, it is basically just getting a black version of the Magic Keyboard. So as we open the box, we can see the Magic Keyboard over here. It is an extended Magic Keyboard, which means you do get these number pads. If you open up more, you'll see that you actually get a black lightning cable, which used to be exclusive to the iMac Pro. And it's very rare that Apple actually bundles in black lightning cables. Even with black iPhones, they do not include a black lightning cable. It's always a white lightning cable. And if you actually pay attention to the details here, if you actually look inside the USB, you can actually see that it's coated in a black paint. And if you actually look at the ends of the lightning cable, it is also black. If you compare that to your white lightning cables, you'll notice that those edges are actually white and that the inside is white as well. But on the black lightning cable, they are color matched to the color of the cable, which is very cool. Unfortunately, there are no black Apple stickers included and just some documentation. So let's go ahead and open up this keyboard over here, peel this off so we can actually get a better look at the Space Gray Magic Keyboard. So it is, as you would expect, a space gray version of the Apple Extended Magic Keyboard. However, this does retail for about $20 more. On Apple's website, it is $149, while the Apple White Extended Keyboard is $129. So you are paying a little bit of a accessory tax just to get this in a different color, but at least it's better than buying on eBay from iMac Pro owners where they're selling it for $1,000. So we can just kind of see the finish of the Space Gray Magic Keyboard. It's a very nice looking keyboard. I don't know if it's really worth the $149. If you really like the black coloring, I guess that would be worth it for you. But let's go ahead and just type on it really quickly. If you have ever used an Apple Magic Keyboard before, it's about the same exact feel. Very shallow keys, not much travel to them, but I actually kind of prefer that now after using a lot of Apple products. I really don't like mushy keys, with the exception of being a mechanical keyboard, which does still feel superior to almost any keyboard, but these keys don't bother me. Let's go ahead and take the Apple White keyboard. It's not an extended keyboard, so you can kind of see the coloring differences here and how much more of a keyboard you're getting. So you're getting additional number pad and down arrow pads. You don't have to really stretch them in as much as you do with the white keyboard, but you can kind of see the coloring differences here and just how much bigger the extended keyboard is. And if we flip the keyboard over, you'll notice the on slider over here. If it's on green, that means it's on, so you can flip that on and off when you're doing your pairing. To pair it, you just have to plug it into the lightning port over here, and it actually charges it too, so the battery lasts about a month when using the keyboard. And you don't have to put any batteries in, it completely has a rechargeable battery, which is very convenient compared to old Apple keyboards. Again, at this point, most Apple users really know if they really enjoy using the Apple keyboards by now. They have a very certain feel to them that some people do have a hard time adjusting to. But again, if you're an Apple owner, if you like the Apple extended keyboard and you want it in black, at least you have the choice to actually buy this keyboard now, as opposed to having to buy a $5,000 iMac Pro. At least Apple offers it, although it would have been nice if it was the same price. Okay, everyone, and that just about does it for this video. I don't know if you want to see a full review of this product. I just thought it would be cool to unbox it and kind of give you a closer look at the Space Gray version of the Magic Keyboard in case you didn't own it and you're thinking about buying it now. But I don't know if you'd actually want to see a full review. If you want to see a full review, let me know in the comments below. Subscribe to my channel to see more, and I will see you in the next video. Take care, everyone.